craze going on, we figured the best thing to do for this old gal would be just to convert her over to electric. How you think? Runs pretty good, right? Real quiet.
Look at all of those chickens.
On you.
Welcome back to the garage. My name is Zane.
And I'm Dustin, and thank you for having me back, Zane. Welcome back to my garage.
This is Dustin's little shed right here to work on projects and get us out of the sun, luckily. The camera would be in like meltdown phase right now.
it's pretty bad. Zane picked the best day to come out yesterday. Perfect.
Today. 9:05.
Not so much.
Dustin, you want to give them a rundown of what you've done so far, kind of during the week when I haven't been here and everything?
Right. During the week, trying to get a little bit of headway made on this thing so we wouldn't have quite as much trouble. All I did was, as you all might recall in the first video, I had the transmission was stuck in reverse. And at the time, we weren't entirely sure. And so we ended up dragging it up on the trailer with it in the start position. And that kicks everything out of gear, so that worked out pretty good. Did a little bit of internet sleuthing and found out that this is pretty common for these tractors. So you just take that cap off, and with a long screwdriver and actually no effort whatsoever, I just popped that sucker right back up into first, back into neutral, and we're good.
The big gear right there was stuck in the reverse position. Wow, focus, come on, please. I have to put my camera all the way in there. Anyway, it was stuck in the reverse position back here, and it slides forward. Come on, focus, please. So all I did was take my handy-dandy ginormous screwdriver here, stuck it down there, pushed it forward, found neutral with it, and now, as you can see, we have full range of movement. We have first, reverse, second, third, and we are now free to move about the cockpit.
With that being out of the way, and being confident that we didn't have a completely junk transmission, even though it is pretty much completely out of oil. Mm-hmm. There's next to nothing in there. But the gears look fine. I think we could just, when we figure out if the engine is going to work it for us, go ahead and probably just change all the fluids and start over fresh. Now onto the hood, if you would. Tried to make sure that these cylinders were a little bit more freed up. And looking through some of your comments and a few other things that I found, glow plugs was probably the way to go. Glow plugs is what I did. And I think we have footage of that that Zane has posted up now.
Mm-hmm. Over, make a short video just kind of going over some of what I think are the repairs that he did. And one of the biggest ones that I've noticed is the, oh, well, that's not good. So this glow plug had what looks like water on it and crud built up on the end of it, so that might be a sign that we need to get into that cylinder. This glow plug seems to be the most intact of all of them, and yet It is coated in water. So guys, I think the back two cylinders on this motor have had or do have water in them. Do have water in them, I imagine. It's a new can. Fortunately, I don't have a nozzle or a pipe for it. I'm just gonna kinda aim and hope for the best. Now, that might be ill-advised to some, but I don't have anything in this tractor right now except for the fuel to go get it and the time. So, let's hook up a battery. Turns over a little bit easier when it doesn't have any compression. I didn't see a bunch of water come out of there, but I definitely got something blowing out.
And so I pulled those out. All those glow plugs are garbage. They're all junk. We have not ordered glow plugs for it. We want to see what we can get done without them. At $40 a piece, they're the most expensive thing that I will have put in this tractor at this point. With the exception of this morning's
Drive to town
for a valve stem core, which we didn't get, and we ended up cobbling stuff together to get this tire aired up.
We got Farmer Dustin, folks. Gotta lift the back of the tractor up and spin the wheel and tire because the valve stem's at the very top in a really bad spot.
Well, which way did it go, George? Which way did it go? Where's the mouses at, George? I don't see no mouses.
Pull those out. They're still finger tight. Got to put them back in, tighten them up before we do much else. Spread a little WD in there just to let things sit. And after turning it over, getting it kind of circulated. Engine is freed up. I don't know that it was entirely necessary to do that, but that is what we have done. Or what I've done, rather. And today, we aired up the tires and we got it down here.
Yep. Got it into the shed, out of the sun. It's only about 94 and a half degrees in here instead of 95 outside.
Yeah, this thing, we're in a metal shed, so it is cooking up top, and we're getting that nice oven baking going on.
Oh, yeah.
I think our plan today is to see what we can get accomplished on this thing, see if we can't get it fired up. I did find some concerns when I pulled the glow plugs. We may have a couple cylinders that had some moisture in them that may have resulted in some rusty injector caps. And I guess we'll see what we can do when we get in there. I think we're going to pop this hood off, get it out of our way, maybe take that fuel tank off, get in there and see what we can find.
Sounds good. Get the impact, get a socket that fits those bolts, and pop the hood off.
Correct. Run it in and out.
Yeah, the end of it looks threaded. It's like it's got a encapsulated nut.
I think it does. But I don't want to break it off.
Yeah, true.
I'm
going
to run it back and forth. One down. Yeah, that's a good looking bolt.
Just turn out of the way.
Yeah.
So I have some room.
It's pretty snug.
Your ear holes.
That one was smooth as butter.
I'm gonna carry it outside so it's not tripping over.
Yeah.
Weight production.
You get stage one?
Stage one, buddy.
Like a race tractor out of it.
Good old PB Blaster.
Uh-oh.
Is it spinning?
I don't know how it would be.
Oh, man.
Considering that it's inside the tank.
You gotta take a really long, messy Ferguson wrench and go inside through the top of the tank.
Shut up.
Buy it at your local Massey dealer.
I might be able to just wedge it up with a screwdriver.
To get it tight.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Because there's a little bit of gap here.
Oh, demonetized.
Demonetized. Cut the audio.
Yeah, dump the audio.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, now I do need a wrench. Oh, here you go. Get them loose and then crack that line to get the tank off.
Yeah, I just want to make sure we get these off. We're going to break in lines loose.
True.
This is a 13, so.
Oh, there you go.
It's got a little bit of play. Oh, it came right off. I was going to be like, I saw play in that wrench.
Is there something to fuel out or no?
Probably. This is going down to the pump, though, so. And I think the fuel pitcock is shut off.
Okay.
I think.
Wouldn't be the worst thing.
Unless this is some right wing one, which is backwards.
Nasty diesel out of it anyway, you know?
Oh, I'm planning on losing the diesel out of it.
Yeah.
I don't plan on keeping none of that.
Perfect.
How about spun down there?
Good.
Mm-hmm.
That's loose.
Hold that tank.
That's the glorious thing about working on diesels. This is like, none of the fittings are usually like rusted solid.
Oh yeah.
Like a gas engine, everything's rusted, eaten away. Diesel's
every one
like,
of those,
self-lubricates.
Every one of those twist off, like brake lines.
Mm-hmm.
It's always miserable trying to, because you think you're gonna crack it loose.
Yeah.
And just twists.
or yeah, the fitting's not.
Has some tension.
That was pretty. Watch that bulb on the bottom.
Oh, it's got the glass?
Yeah, it's made into the tank.
Hey, it don't look too bad. The old air bloater after it.
The fuel tank is removed, which gives us better access to the top of this engine, just in case the valve cover has to come off of here. You can see the injectors a lot better, and we can get to everything that we need to and not have the tank in the way. So get the camera set up, Dustin's going to use some compressed air and get the engine cleaned off on top. And then we're going to get back to it.
What are you doing leaking? Why are you?
I'll stand out of the way so you
can clean that off.
Looked off to the corner of his garage and it took my attention away for a moment. I like all these old hand tools. You can see I found a 3/4 inch drive. I'm assuming this is an Industro. It could be an old Proto, but this is an open gear ratchet. You can see the mechanism works just like a regular ratchet. You see the tooth inside. You gotta click it over manually to go the opposite direction. It actually has this cover. If the cover wasn't on here, you could see the exposed gear itself. But that's an oldie right there. I'm guessing probably 50s. And actually, now that I see, it's actually a Thorsen ratchet. They don't make them like they used to. Okay. Mic check?
Mic check.
That's right, we don't have a mic.
We're taking the valve cover off.
Yep.
Because we figured, why run the risk of having stuck valves and trying to get this thing to hit
exactly
off of a little aerosol persuasion with the fuel tank and whatnot off of it. Just gonna go that route.
Yep.
But make sure that these valves aren't stuck first.
Could be a rubber mallet after it. Make sure we don't have a seal busting.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just off here.
Ooh. Pull that up, Lyle.
Yep.
Guide it. That's not coming out. I think it's fastened down low.
Okay. I'll take the screwdriver over here. Pop it apart. What'd it look like? You got a sneak peek?
We got a sneak peek of the dry valve stream.
Huh. Tools that we think we need.
Gotta clean this shop. The struggle of anybody who works on anything, keeping the shop clean.
If anybody has a table in their shop that's spotless, it's suspicious.
It's true.
Because anybody that works on stuff, even on the weekends like we all do, things pop up and you need to stop one job to finish another one.
Yep.
That's just the way it works.
That's the way of it too. You gotta stop one thing, start another one. You got an emergency, you need to go take care of it, come back, you're tired. Nah, I'll mess with that tomorrow.
Let me get close.
Close? Glenn close?
Yeah. Not bad at all, really.
I doubt we have anything stuck.
No, it doesn't look like it.
This has got silicone.
No sludge in it though. I mean, not like it's... Of course, it would have settled probably by now.
It would have settled up, but...
Still. No sign of moisture at all. Little bit of rust.
That is a little bit of rust on top.
That's probably,
I thought it fell off of the valve cover. Though,
that's really close to where the blow-by tube was, though, so it might have migrated up from there.
Now, let us...
Almost spin it over and watch them, right?
Well, what I was going to do was tap on them and make sure that they're free.
Oh, okay.
Before... That one's free. That one's open, so it has to be free.
Yeah, let me say something.
Whoa, look at this.
Ooh, the light.
What is
off.
This?
Make sure it's out of gear, too. Take off.
Starts.
How did it
get that out of there?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
You know what? At the end, I cranked this thing over the whole time yesterday with that in there.
Oh, nice.
It didn't go anywhere.
We'll give you a close-up of the valves opening and closing. It looks like everything's freed up, so we'll hit the battery, hit the key.
They're moving.
Looks promising, folks.
One of these
is bound to fit.
Either this one or this one will break loose.
There you go.
Oh, wow.
Perfect. Take this whole set of lines off of it, I think.
Yeah, I am going to do that. This is the easy ones. The big ones are on the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
This is just the return lines. I don't really care about these guys. I'll just peep diesel fuel all over the ground on the time. I don't know. This thing should have hit off of ether, but
maybe EPA wants to know your location.
Do you need diesel like, and ether firewallings?
I wouldn't think so.
I wouldn't think so either.
I think you can just run.
But I guess they run off of compression, so, like. Yeah.
There you go. Perfect.
That guy was taught by a school.
Although he's got some school.
I guess I was taught, we were taught by school. I still don't know the name of everything.
Oh, ah! Smash your thumbnail?
Oh no! Thumbnail casualty! Ouchie!
Oh, yeah.
That's a piece.
Piece of the thumbnail.
Ow!
Piece of your thumbnail in the thumbnail.
Oh, that's hurting.
It ain't bleeding, is it?
No, but it hurts.
There you go, you should be good.
Oh, wait. Shoot.
Look alright. You don't look like it's rusted up a little bit. Might have to hold it a little closer. You tell us.
I don't think it's... Yeah, you tell us. I think we'll clean them off and see.
Yeah.
What happens.
That one. There wasn't no crud on that one.
Yeah, this one was easy. Doesn't look much better than those, but...
Mm-hmm.
That one had like dirt dollars in it.
Yeah.
Dirty dabbers.
There you go.
Why is it not coming out though? Am I prying against the engine block or something?
Hold on, let me get there. Looks like a little bit of trash down there.
No! Oh.
The trash was holding it.
Yeah! That's not the dumbest thing here for a while, though.
Close to it.
Well, that one's pretty rusty.
And there you have it. You made it to the end of this video in the tractor series. If you've watched the video all the way through and have made it to this point, I greatly appreciate you taking the time out of your day to do so. It truly means a lot. All the subscriptions, the thumbs up, the kind comments left in the comment section down below truly helps me out and really inspires me and Dustin to get this tractor going. Now, there has been some work done off camera. It's not made it into a video just yet, but I think the next time I go and help him, this tractor is going to start up and run. I would have liked to have had him in the end of this video, but he's about an hour and 20 minutes, roughly that direction, so it's just me at the end of this video. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed this journey. I mean, I'm not a diesel mechanic, neither is Dustin. We're basically learning about this machine as we go, and hopefully it does inspire some people to maybe work on something that they don't really know like the back of their hand. I'm not one of these channels that'll buy something, drag it out of the woods, do a little bit of work to it, and get it running in the same episode. Those videos are enjoyable, but just like the shows that were on TV years ago, like, you know, Overhauling or something like that, where they take a car and repaint it and completely restore it in a week, there's a lot of smoke and mirrors. I mean, they're cutting out huge chunks of the video where they're waiting for parts or they order something and it shows up wrong. I kind of see this as more of a journey, as you're watching two friends work on something and watching it unfold in real time. But anyways, hopefully you're enjoying this video series. If you are, please give the video a thumbs up, leave a comment or question down below. Consider subscribing if this is the kind of content that you're into. And as always, just a friendly reminder that it doesn't matter if you're working on your project in a garage or in your driveway. What matters is that you go out there, you do the job yourself, and you learn more about your project, whatever that project may be. Now that this video is over, how about you go outside and work on something? My name's Zane, and I'll catch you next time.